U.S. Nationals, took out the Hawaiian Cars, Snidely, Sorokin, Gary Dawson, Tom McEwen, final round for James Warren, and Big Daddy came with a game to do. Woo! 6-second lane, and said that he would not shave that beard until he made a 6-second run. He did it in the final round, the biggest race, the U.S. Nationals, on tires that he borrowed from the guy that he ran in the final, James Warren. His helmet's off. Let's hear it for Big Daddy. Yeah! In the final round, Big Daddy Tom Garlits. This is the car that he won the race with. We got the shaving cream.
This means it's shaving time.
Did you think you could beat him in that final round?
It was something else, let me tell you.
Now, who is happier when you finally shave your beard, you or your wife, Pat?
My wife. She liked it the best.
That was a straggly look. He did that when he went 72 hours without shaving his car. So he came down here and the U.S. Nationals win. His daughters are down there with him now in the winner's circle to shave it just like he did back then. One more time, ladies and gentlemen. On top of two alcohol guys, got a big race before you and a whole pile of shaving cream.
Look at these ones over here.
One of the tiny goals for sport drag racing.
He's a big horse.
Big Daddy, that had been your entire career, was the greatest moment ever.
It certainly was. I mean, you know, it was like a Cinderella story because, you know, coming here qualifying 23rd in a field of 32 cars, working your way all the way through 5 rounds in an afternoon, and winning the race. I mean, a complete underdog coming into the event.
I'm borrowed tires!
Meeting, and, you know, they were doing a special TV special, Fram was, and Frank McGonigal from Frank in prison said, this is just like a Hollywood script that we came here and produced it.
You hadn't qualified in the first 2 races of the year. Your competitors were saying that you're washed up, you should stay home.
Yeah, you know, we almost didn't come to the event because we didn't qualify at the Winter Nationals or the Spring Nationals.
And you said you went 72 hours working on that car. Your wife, God bless her, set 4 times a day aside so you guys could eat, but you didn't stop working until you got that car done.
That's exactly right. Of course, we never took time to shave.
Yeah. From the bottom of my heart, you should have. Ladies and gentlemen, Big Daddy Tom Garlits.
Big Daddy!
Our friends from the top 2 alcohol crew worked overtime, just like Big Daddy did, 72 hours to get all the shaving cream, the razor, all that set. His daughters are here with us. You can see him over there, display over there in the pit area after this go. And Don, just the response you've got from the fans here just tells you how much we all love you and everything you've done for the sport of drag racing.
Amen.
I just said the fans love you.
Oh, I love the fans. They don't love me anymore, and I love them.
Hey!
My entire career was based on the fans. That's why I went to the little burning stumps in the Lebanon Valley and did my 2 out of 3 match races, and that's how I got famous. I got famous before TV.
Yeah! One more time. Ladies and gentlemen, Big Daddy Don Garlits.
That was really cool. It might be the first time in history I've said, We're going to need a new windsock because we got too much shaving cream on the microphone there. Congratulations, Jake. Thanks to all you fans for being such a special deal. Hey, we've got final qualifying to figure out who's going to race for this year's Top Fuel Trophy. Coming up momentarily, thank you for joining our magic on the racetrack. If you thought that
Top Fuel racer, your team might make the passes in the 6 second frame.
What's the point?
The beard is Garlits, made it to the final at the sport's biggest event, the U.S. National. Big Daddy did his job win the race. He turned in ET at 6.7 seconds. Garlits made good on his promise, and fans poured onto the track in Indianapolis to watch the legend, Dave, and the people.